note is that everything is customizable, from a login logo to indeed the landing page itself. You can add your own graphics or you can work from templates. In fact, if you wanted to, you can have session variables, so when we log in, depending upon who we are, we see a different graphic or logo, whatever it may be. We can add buttons, completely customizable, that can link, in this case, to our Facebook page, but these could be events on the IBM I itself. Let's have a look at the look and feel. Well, first thing you can notice that we've got some buttons along the top. Again, these were added by myself, completely customizable, and a live date field there as well, using iframes. Other things using iframes is the widgets, web widgets. In this case, I've got a weather feed from BBC and a Google map here that we can see where we are that corresponds to the postcode at the bottom. In addition, I've added a couple of adverts that we can click through to see Meet the Nicholsons or ask more about engines, and a live transaction coming from the IBM I itself for our knowledge base. Real-time OLAP reports. This is an incredibly powerful bit of this system, as it allows for real-time interrogation of the IBM I data. We set up a couple here, let's have a look at these. So in this particular case, we're interrogating a sales cube that resides on the IBM I. We can drill down into various years and months and see the information live. And in fact, this is quicker than using a green screen 5250. We're not having to pass information through, such as the headers and footers, just simply that information that we want to. Now we can add filters here, in this case we don't, to greater than, less than, equal to, whatever it may be. And we can also extract this information to a spreadsheet. And if we wanted to, we could add pivot tables or whatever we needed from there. So extremely quick, extremely powerful way to analyze information in real time from the IBM I. In addition, we can see this information in any format we want, in a bar chart, a graph, whatever it may be, in this case a bar chart. So we can summarize by putting our mouse over each individual chart, or we could drill down to various levels there also. Mobilization in the workforce is key these days, and this solution allows for just this. Using device recognition, we can change the interface depending upon what device we log in at. Now in this particular case, I've created a reports menu that's pertinent for the iPad with, well, bigger buttons. So you log in and instead of accessing the reports via the hyperlinks, you simply click on the big buttons and we can scroll down and view the information accordingly. If we wanted to, we could drill down just by simply pressing on that particular part of the graph. So quick and easy, and extremely fast to deploy due to very little information being transmitted. But what of creating live transactions on the IBM I database itself via the web portal? Well, we've created a little scenario where we're saying here that we are a partner logging into the portal and we want to ask customer services a question on a particular price for a component. So I enter the component details and hit submit. That makes that transaction on the database in real time. Now what we see is that it's automatically updated the portal through the knowledge base with that particular question. And we can search that knowledge base using filters if we wish. Now, let's say that we are the customer services representative who's logging in to view any questions that have been submitted. So we'll log into the portal and I see the whole list of questions that are to the sales department. There's all the questions and there's the one right at the top that we just asked. Now you'll also notice that the graphic in the top, the welcome graphic, has changed. Using session variables, as I'm logging in as someone else, that's changed also. So let's answer this question. So please provide the price for XCV, and the price is X per unit. When I update the record, it automatically writes to the database in the background on the IBM I, and it's refreshed in the browser. And finally, let's log in as the question originator. So I look at my knowledge base to see if that question is still there. Yes, it is. It was asked on then, and has it been answered? Well, I see on the right-hand column there, yes, it has. I can click on the hyperlink to see the response, and there it is. There's price per dollar per unit. Thank you very much. And all this and more was created in just under 2 days. To learn more, please see the description details below.